मत्पुण्यगाथाश्रवणाभिधानैः तथा तथा पश्यति वस्तु सूक्ष्मं चक्षुर्यथैजान् संप्रयुक्तम्। He says that listening to my leelas, if you really are doing smaran, meaning you're hearing the leela and it's entering your heart and you're allowing that leela to be in your heart, then what happens is your heart is gradually purified. Like when, let's say you have a temporary blindness and you put some Ayurvedic ointment on your eyes that is going to cure that blindness. What happens is gradually, see, initially it's all dark for you. Then as you start to be healed, you just see, oh, I can make out some light. But you can't see anything still. Then you make out some shadowy forms, but everything is fuzzy and black and white. As your eye gets cured more, you start to make out forms and colors, and eventually your sight becomes crystal clear. Shri Krishna says, just like that, I am right here with you, but you can't see. It's like there's a veil between you and me. That veil is the impurity of your own heart. Remove that and I'm right here. How do you remove that? My leelas are the great purifier. Listen to my leelas, meditate on my leelas, bring them in your heart gets cleaned out, and gradually, just like you gradually regain your eyesight, gradually the fact that I'm right here with you starts to become apparent to you. You start to feel, Shri Krishna is right here with me. When you do Rup Dhyan, it's not feeling like just your imagination anymore. You're feeling and seeing Shri Krishna right here with you. And that goes on intensifying more and more and more until the day our heart is 100% pure, we're 100% surrendered to Shri Krishna, then real Shri Krishna is there, right in front of us. We meet Him face to face. That's God realization, Bhagavat Prapti. That's the ultimate goal of a soul, to meet Shri Krishna face to face. Your divine beloved to whom you are eternally related, but you've been forever separated from. Not because He's far, but because our heart is impure. We're not surrendered to Him, so we're unable to experience Him. We're unable to realize His absolute closeness with us. So that's the ultimate goal of our soul. Aside from all of the physical duties and responsibilities we have in our life that are related to our body, our deeper goal that's related to our soul is to meet Shri Krishna face to face. And the process of reaching that point is called bhakti. And the material that we need, He's already given to us in the form of Bhagavatam. Take those leelas, hear those leelas, listen to them, meditate on them. You'll clean your heart and you're getting closer to that state of God realization. So this is what Bhagavatam is for us. It has important philosophy to understand, and it also has the leelas of Shri Krishna, which will purify our heart if we listen to them faithfully. So this is a brief introduction to the Bhagavatam. This same series I've given in a little bit longer previously, so there are some videos available on YouTube. So if you want to hear a little bit longer introduction, I've given I think 7 one-hour speeches just introducing what is Bhagavatam, which is available on YouTube. I can give you a card afterwards if anyone wants that has the actual website where these videos are embedded. This gives you, I hope, a good idea of what is the Bhagavatam, what's its importance, what can be gained by listening to the Bhagavatam. Tomorrow we'll be having satsang not here, but somewhere nearby, I think, right? How far is it from here? 45 minutes. I didn't know Trinidad was that big. Okay, so it's not that close, but you're still invited. You can talk to Indira, and I'll be continuing on Bhagavatam tomorrow, and we'll be back here again at the same time on Monday. What I'd like to finish with, however, tonight is, since you've got some appreciation for the greatness of the leelas of the Bhagavatam now, I'll tell you one brief leela about Shri Krishna in the Bhagavatam, and we'll finish with a little bit of kirtan, and then we'll have the aarti. If you'd like, you can close your eyes and you can visualize this leela. Just like he was saying, the leela has to enter your heart. So try to do like Shukadev ji. When you hear it, try to visualize the whole thing. Shri Krishna lived in Vrindavan, Gokul, Nandagaon, all these beautiful villages of Braj. And when he was old enough, his family's Purohit, Gargacharya, he came and advised Mother Yashoda and Nanda Baba that now your son, Shri Krishna, he's old enough to go out and graze the calves, not the full-grown cows, but the babies, the calves. He was only 5 years old, which is quite young, but there were older boys in the neighborhood, so they would take care of Shri Krishna. It was the auspicious time for him to go out and begin grazing the cows. So every day, Shri Krishna used to go out grazing, and there was a particular style. Even today in Braj, those who graze the cows, they do it barefoot, for one. Vedas tell that when you're grazing the cows, you should be barefoot. And even today, all the local kids who go out and graze the cows, they do it together. So however many cows you have, you go out with your lunch, because you're going out for the whole day. You meet up with your neighbor who also has some cows, and as you keep heading out to the fields, another neighbor comes and joins in. So all the neighborhood boys would meet Shri Krishna. We call them the Gwalbals. They would all be dressed up in their village country style, beautifully decorated with some kind of headband or turban, wearing a colorful dhoti, some kind of shawl around their shoulders, a stick for herding the cows, and a little satchel with lunch that their mother had prepared for them. So each of the boys had his lunch. And you can imagine Shri Krishna, he is the very form of bliss, the very form of beauty, the very form of divine love. What is the greatness of the fortune of these boys who get to have Shri Krishna as their very own friend? And they meet with him just like you would meet with your best friend. Oh, Kanha, oh, Kanhaiya, here I am, let's go. I have my lunch. What did your mother pack for you today? And all the boys meet up and head out with their calves, carrying their lakuti, the stick, and their lunch satchel. And Shri Krishna poured the bliss through his loving interaction with these boys, with his friends. So instead of behaving as serious, supreme God, he he left aside his godliness in order to be friends with these boys. And these boys are also saints, but they are not consciously thinking about the fact that Shri Krishna is God. They want him as their friend. So they just love him as a friend, and they don't even mind about the fact that he's God. So as they're walking, they're telling jokes together. They stop and find some colorful clays, and they decorate each other's cheeks and arms and chest by smearing on some different lines of colored clay. Some boy finds some colorful feathers, so they decorate their turbans and their hair with some feathers. Someone else finds some beautiful flowers, so they add some flowers to their decorations. As they're walking, one of the boys may grab the lunch satchel of someone else, and then he's trying to get it back, so he throws it to another boy. And he runs over to him, so he throws it to another boy, and everybody's laughing, and they finally give it back to him. Sometimes Shri Krishna goes on ahead, and all the boys run to see who could touch him first. And they all come in a big scram around Shri Krishna. They head out and they reach their destination place where the calves can happily graze on some lush green grass. And now it's time to enjoy, because all the boys don't have to be watching the calves all the time. One or two boys can look after everybody's calves, so they take turns. And the rest of the boys play with Shri Krishna. So he may be playing a tune on his flute, and as he's playing, a couple of the boys are dancing. Then some wrestling starts up. Even Shri Krishna gets in the act and wrestles with those boys. Afterwards, they have some rest in the shade of a big, beautiful tree. Shri Krishna putting his head in the lap of Balaram, and the other boys feeling happy to press his legs as Shri Krishna rests and takes a little nap. When they wake up, when Shri Krishna wakes up, they have some lunch together. All the boys sit around Shri Krishna with him in the middle. And they all unwrap their lunch satchel and excitedly start sharing, "Oh, Kanha, my mom gave me some samosa. Here, have a bite." And then one boy sees, "Oh, your mom gave you dahi vada. Your mom gave you some laddu, sweet balls. I want some of that." And he snatches some food from Kanhaiya. In this way, the boys are laughing and joking and sharing the food around. And they pass their time like this. Over here, one of the Gwalbals sees a peacock dancing, and so he starts mocking the peacock, calling out to him and trying to imitate his dance. Another couple boys see some monkeys up in the trees and start chasing the monkeys around in the trees. So in this way, Shri Krishna is sharing this childhood fun with these boys and gracing them with his personal friendship. And these leelas are described in the Bhagavatam so that we can also learn to love Shri Krishna as a friend, or as our own son, or as our beloved. And by meditating on these simple, sweet childhood leelas, we're joining our mind with the divinity. We're doing smaran, which is the heart and soul of devotion. At the end, in the late afternoon, Shri Krishna with all the boys and all the calves, makes his way back, and all the boys return to their individual homes and meet their mothers. Shri Krishna's mother Yashoda has been waiting for him. She happily bathes him and dresses him and feeds him. And in this way, every day, Shri Krishna is giving the bliss of his divine friendship to his friends. To his mother, he's giving Vatsalya Prem, the love that a mother has for a child and a child has for a mother. Many different types of Prem Shri Krishna revealed in his descension here. And all of that is described in the Bhagavatam for our own devotional use. So now we'll finish with a little bit of kirtan. You can keep doing Roop Dhyan of Shri Krishna. Think of any other leela of his that you know. Or make up a new leela of your own liking. As long as you're thinking of him, your mind will continue to be purified.
Radhe, Radhe, Govinda, Bhajo. Radhe, Radhe, Govinda.
Radhe, Radhe, Govinda.
Govinda bhajo Radhe Radhe Govinda
for the arti.
Jayati jagad guru guru var ki gao mili arti rasik var ki gao gao mili arti rasik var ki guru pad nakh mani chandrika prakash जाके उर बसे ताके मोहतम नाश जाके माथ नाथ तव हाथ करवास ताते होए माया मोह सब ही निराश पावे गति वति रति अनावर की जाओ मिली आर की रसिक वर की जाओ जाओ मिली आर की रसिक वर की अरे मन मोड़ छान नारी नर हार गुरु बिनु ब्रह्म श्याम ना देंगे सार कोमल कृपाल बड़े कृपा सिंधु नार पाते में आज तू अनाथ हो सनार के आगे कृपा की गाओ मिले आरती रसिक वर की गाओ गाओ मिले आरती रसिक वर की भक्ति योग रस अवतार अभिराम करे निगमागम समन्वय लीला गुणधाम बात करे प्रेम निष्काम विनुदान Sadona Sumilas Chaya Divya Drishti Vichya Prema Taprakash Vaisahi Vinod Vahi Manjur Mriduhas Kari Mast Bar Mast Uccha Attahas Yume Chali Chal
तम प्यारी की बनवारी नतवारी
आरती प्रीतम प्यारी की बनवारी नतवारी दुहुन सिर कनक मुकुट जल के दुहुन श्रुति सीले बैन रसीले बैन गसीले सैन दुन मैं नन मन हारी की बनवारी नतवारी आरती प्रीतम प्यारी की बनवारी नतवारी चितवनि परवारी दुहुन लट लट करि छवि न्यारी दुहुनि भावत करि अति प्यारी रसन मुख पान रसन मुस्कान रसन रमकान